Alright, we're ready for the final bout with the great Michael Jackson. His final album, Invincible. Ladies and gents in Cyberland, coming back to another album review, and this is pretty much the final album that Michael released in his lifetime. It's a little bittersweet, you know. It has its happy moments and its sad moments, and it's a shame that it didn't end like for me like Linkin Park or Stone Temple Pilots to a degree, but it's just a shame that this is, you know, this last of what we'll ever get from Mike, so. Invincible. There was something that I wanted to say. Excuse me just a second. So, I was already in college when this album came out, and I remember I went to one of my friend's house. He had it. He acquired it, and we listened to it. But before the album came out, there was a song, Rock My World, which I, out of all the songs that he had come out with prior to that, I was just kind of like, Rock My World was cool. It wasn't like, it didn't hit me like all the other songs that had come out previously for each album. I think it was a bad song. I was just like, kind of like, eh, it's all right. The video was funny, though, having Chris Tucker, because, you know, Chris Tucker with Rush Hour and mimicking a lot of things about Mike, and I think they became good friends over that or something like that. It was kind of funny, but the song was, it was all right. It wasn't bad. It just didn't grab me like the other singles that came out from the albums prior to it. And this album dropped, and you know, I felt. It was a step up from history. It was a lot more lighthearted and not dark. There were still some songs that were trying to let people know that I'm still around, I can still make music, and I can still do my thing. And he was right about that. As far as the fan opinion and public opinion, you know, the media, of course, were trying to lambast him and wrote him off, and were just like, fuck them, because they, you know, they just needed a target, and they felt like they wanted to bring him down just because of what he was capable of, and they felt they did, which they didn't. They never did. But they felt they did. And this album came out, and I think it got kind of mixed reviews. Me, already my rating, I give it 8 out of 10 yes sirs. I didn't have an issue with it. The funny thing is, for a long time, I thought the song 2000 Watts, which I really loved, I thought that was somebody else singing the song. Come to find out that was him, but they did something to his vocals to make it lower, or he sang it lower to where you think it was somebody else, which was really cool. I never looked into that until recently, found that out. But I enjoyed the album for the most part. I thought the songs were good. They weren't like bad or dangerous or even, you know, off the wall or Thriller. You know, I think Mike at that point had passed that to where he can make songs, but he wasn't trying to outdo what he already did. He was just like, I'm just going to make music at this point to make music. I don't have anything to prove anymore, and I'll still tour for my fans and stuff, and I'll still make music if I can, but I don't think he was trying to outdo the songs he did before. He wasn't going to make bad songs per se, but he just wasn't trying to keep trying to compete with what he's done in the past. Like, I think this album was just like, here's the theme of it, here's a bunch of songs that I feel revolve around that album to an extent, and take it for what it is. If you enjoy it, great. If you don't, you don't. I felt he was a lot more calm and at peace when he released this album as opposed to History or His Story and even Dangerous. I felt with this, he was just kind of at a place where his mindset was different. He had kids, and I think Mike was at the point where he wanted to still do music, but he was more so on lines of, I'm not interested in trying to compete against other artists per se, or trying to feel like I have to pump something out. Because I heard over the years, before this album and after he had passed and stuff, that he had done a lot of tracks with different artists, a lot of rappers and stuff, and then just some of the stuff is sitting in the vault and it just hasn't been released. And that's, you know, that's how it is for a lot of artists. Was anything I didn't like, if I already didn't say that? I felt the album flowed very well, and from when it started to where it ended, it was fine. Everything felt right in place when I listened to it, and as I still do listen to it, maybe not as much as the other material, but I still listen to it, and I wasn't disappointed with it. I mean, I was sad, you know, when he passed away and how he passed away. That hit a lot of people, a lot of the fans and stuff, including myself. Maybe not as much as maybe like some of the artists I listened to, but it was a shock and it was a shame, you know, everything he had done. And we always felt like, I know he can put out some more music, you know, and this is kind of where it stopped. Because everything, I will not be reviewing anything past this point, because I don't feel that the post-mortem, I think that's what they call it, I don't feel that should be even worth my time, because that wasn't sanctioned by him. And at this point, it's just a cash grab to where I'm trying to get people to buy stuff that Mike would have wrote. I'm like, now if you want to release B-sides for the albums that came out prior, that's okay. But if you're trying to release like post-mortem albums and stuff, I'm just like, I'm not interested. Because I, as big of a perfectionist as he was, if those songs as old as they were, if they didn't come out when he was alive, they probably weren't meant to come out. So, top five traps, top five tracks were Unbreakable, Threatened, 2000 Watts, Butterflies, and Speechless. Honorable mention, I would say, Invincible. I really liked how that song goes. When you put it up against Unbreakable. So, I don't think there's much more to it. I think Mike had a good run for what he did. He changed the world in regards to the music he put out. Some people are always just going to like Thriller and not bother with other albums, and some people are just going to like this albums he came out in the 80s, and then everything that happened in the 90s, they just wrote them off. Me personally, I could care less about all that stuff at the moment. I just care about the music and how it made me feel, and very fortunate to be able to still listen to this stuff and enjoy it for what it is and what it was, you know, stuff. So I would say go in order. If don't listen to this album first, listen to where he started, and then this is where it ends. I would go that way. I wouldn't be like, listen to this first. It's a totally different beast when compared to Off the Wall, Thriller, and Bad, and then of course Dangerous. You know, I mean, History and this album, it's like History was the conflict album, and this is like the resolution album kind of thing. That's how it feels to me. So, But otherwise, you know, key the music.